Stay off my lens, he says, and pops his hands to books. He leans over the telescope, peers through the eyepiece, and tries to adjust the focus again. No matter how magnified, out there is still too far to fathom. He steps back from the telescope and lies in the grass. The weight of his body on the earth, heavy and real. The distance of the stars in the sky, luminous and untouchable. Though the vastness of deep space fascinated Caleb, it was too intangible to give him comfort, much like his mom's stories. While watching a documentary on astronomy, Caleb absorbed everything Carl Sagan says. If you wish to make an apple pie from scratch, you must first invent the universe. He thinks about the changing seasons, dying flowers and melting snow, how things vanish. He thinks about the harvest, giant sunflowers and fields of food, how things materialize. If to invent the universe, all you need are those basic elements and an observer, then anything is possible. Anything can happen. Other dimensions and other worlds could exist, but we are confined to live in and witness only one. And if anything can materialize in any given world, perhaps whatever we hold closest to us can vanish as well. Caleb finds theories, wormhole theories, and multiverse theories, but for Caleb, his lack of solid evidence shatters any truth. He wanders the aisles of his school's library until he finds the science shelves. Aside from some books on physical science and a couple astronomy books for kids, the section lacks what Caleb hopes to find. Parallel worlds, wormholes, extraterrestrial life. The elementary school librarian peers at him over her wiry eyeglasses and shakes her head. You aren't going to find these topics here. These shelves are reserved for real science. She guides him to the science fiction shelves, smiles, and leans into brows. Caleb squints the books. Stories about parallel realities, time travel, and alien worlds. His mom's story would fit perfectly. Back in the classroom, a heaviness arises in the pit of Caleb's stomach, and his mind becomes circles as his classmates practice for the spelling quiz. He lays his head on the desk and stares out the window at the blue, cloudless sky, the sun shrouding everything with brightness. In a blink, I was there, and then I wasn't. Caleb, are you planning on participating in today? His teacher's sharp voice, a distant echo. He doesn't acknowledge her question or move his head from his desk. The deeper Caleb sinks into his thoughts, the more unraveled his perspective becomes. Perhaps this is why he grounds himself so firmly in the tangible, and this need for assurance is why everything can unravel